What's going on, guys? This is Raymond Ironbody McKinney, and today I want to talk about life is your playground. It's how you make it. And I want to read a message that I recently put on here that has everything to do with our self-image. And we're not violating any of the universal laws or anything like that. We're not violating people's free will when we change our inner image of ourselves in relation to the universe around us. So here it goes. I'm going to share this message. I always love to emphasize that self-image is the greatest gift you can ever work with. It's no accident the kind of people you are with right now. One who talks riches often will attract those who have riches. One who talks sports often will attract others who are in sports. One who talks music often will attract others who are in music. One who talks astrophysics, astronomy, mathematics often will attract those who are also into astrophysics, astronomy, and mathematics. One who talks romance often will attract those who are into romance. You get where I'm going with this. They all have one thing in common: the deep desire and interest of exploring the expansiveness of the mind. I will tell you from experience, nothing will change in one's life until self-image is changed. One may think that forcing external change can also work through conflict, but that only manifests more conflict. Relatively speaking, one must observe the behavior of the person in the mirror with discernment. And that mirror must change when the self-image is consistently practiced, when often perceived relatively differently. So basically changing the inner assumptions within yourself, and that mirror will conform. That outer image will relatively conform. One's self-image directs all thoughts and physical behaviors, and the events, people, and circumstances relatively reflect that physical subconscious behavior within oneself. One isn't violating any universal laws or others' free will when changing self-image. All is in perfect orchestrated order. All places, events, and circumstances take place now within the imagination, which contains all past, present, and future events. This also doesn't violate the theory of Einstein's theory of relativity, the E=mc², stating that nothing travels faster than the speed of light, and that space and time do not actually exist beyond this point, which is within imagination. And that since everything takes place right now in imagination,
within the infinitude creation, projected outward through the sensory factors of the human being, change your self-image, change your life. Play with this stuff, guys. Life is your playground.
So when I talk about this, it basically comes down to consciousness. Consciousness reveals our relative realities. Consciousness is the one and only true reality. And don't
misinterpret it as consciousness controls everyone else. You're not controlling anyone. Consciousness, such as the observer effect, you're not changing anything outside of you. What you actually do, you can't change anything outside of you until that inner image within you changes. And that thing outside of you relatively conforms to your inner assumption.
You're not going against any, you're not violating anyone's free will, guys. You're not violating the laws of the universe or anything like that. You're participating in the laws of the universe with your imagination.
That all is contained within imagination, the collective imagination, projected outward.
So that's some pretty effing deep stuff, guys. Like I brought up in here, nothing travels faster than the speed of light, meaning everything happens simultaneously in the moment right now in imagination. Events in the past, present, and future all contained within the collective consciousness of human imagination.
This is where Neville Goddard, I believe, is where he's bringing all this very complex science and makes it to the simplest point that we can... all we have to do is change our self-concept, guys. We don't change anything outside of us. When we think we have to change something outside of us, we're only manifesting external change. We're focusing on external circumstances. You have to change the inner concept. You have to change the self-concept if you want to see a change within your life, in your favor. Change your inner assumptions. Change your relative outer circumstances conforming to your inner assumptions, your inner image, your inner speech, and how you see yourself in relation to the universe. Again, you're not changing anything by looking outside of yourself. You look within, you assume within, and that's what's projected outward to the screen of space. It's based, I like to see it as like a, almost like a big planetarium. We're seeking the infinitude creation from within. So, everything's in divine orchestrated order. You're not violating any laws of the universe. You're not violating mathematics. You're not violating anything. You're participating in this grand play we call life. And the eternal infinitude creation is within. Life is forever, guys. Life is forever. So, I hope this video helps, because I thought this was a pretty cool message to share. And again, I want to end it with the simplest message possible. Change the way you see yourself in relation to the world. Change the inner assumptions within yourself. Your life's going to change for the relative to your inner assumptions, inner dominant assumptions. Through affirming, scripting, visualizing, eavesdropping, hearing that you're that person, you're not changing anyone, guys. You're changing the conception of yourself. And people are going to be moved to your inner conception of yourself. Automatically. This is beautiful, guys. This is powerful stuff. So, I hope this video helps. I bless y'all and happy manifesting.